Hey guys, confession time. I love naps. I love to nap. And if you're like me, you might want to know, are naps good for you? But I want to talk about the benefits, the drawbacks of naps, how naps work, and how to get the best nap possible. But just a heads up, Casper financially supported this video and also sent me this great mattress and sheets to try out. I had a great napping experience on the Casper, but now let's talk about naps. Now, I'm sure a lot of you are here to find out, are naps good for you? Are they beneficial? And there are some definite benefits. So one of the first benefits is it can help with your memory. They've done studies that people who take naps have an easier time remembering things they learned earlier in the day. Also, it can improve your mood. And I think we all know that if you take a nice, healthy nap, you wake up feeling better, less frustrated, less grumpy. I can personally say this is true. There's also heart disease. It actually lowers your chances of heart disease. They've done some studies that people who nap on a regular basis have a lower chance of having coronary heart disease later in their life. There's also alertness. They've done studies with NASA that pilots who sleep on a daily basis are more alert. And then finally, one of the main reasons we all take naps, to feel better, to get rest. And it has been shown people who take the right length of nap wake up feeling more rested. They've even shown that people who take regular naps are less likely to get into drowsy and driving accidents. Okay, while there are some benefits, there are also some drawbacks to taking naps. The first one is if you take too many naps or take a nap too late in the day, it can actually affect your nighttime sleep. So you actually have trouble going to sleep at night, you struggle with insomnia, this can actually exacerbate the issue. And secondly, this is a big one, is sleep inertia. Now, sleep inertia is that feeling when you come out of a nap or come out of sleep and you feel groggy, it takes a while to kind of wake up. That actually is counterproductive. So you go into a nap to actually feel more rest and you come out feeling worse. That's definitely a drawback. So those are the pros and cons, but I also want to tell you, if you want more information about naps, we have a great ultimate guide to naps. All you have to do to find it is Google Mattress Clarity plus naps, some amazing information there for you. Now, a big thing to consider when you're taking a nap is the length of the nap. And to talk about that, we have to talk about sleep stages. So there are four sleep stages followed by REM sleep. Now, you wanna think about stage one and stage two. Stage one and stage two is gonna be about 10 to 30 minutes. Now, that's your sweet spot for a nap. You're getting some nice rest, but you're not going too deep. You're not gonna wake up feeling groggy. You get into stage three and stage four, between 30 and 90 minutes, you're going deeper. You get woken up, again, you're groggy, you feel that sleep inertia as well. Then you go into REM sleep after that, that's deep nighttime sleep. So if you're thinking about your nap length, you wanna shoot for that 10 to 30 minute window. So what are some ways to get the best nap possible? I already talked about the duration of the nap, that 10 to 30 minute window, but you also wanna think about what time of day you're actually taking the nap. So let's say you're a 9-to-5 worker like I am. You wanna shoot for 2 to 3 p.m. It's not too early, not too late. You have a cool boss, close the door, have a nice siesta. Also, if you're a shift worker, you might wanna actually move it later or a little bit earlier. Think about your sleep position too. So some people nap in their chair. It's better to find a place you can lie down, preferably a mattress. Again, Casper sent us their mattress and I thought it was a great mattress to nap on. And then finally, just practice basic sleep hygiene. So you want a cool, dark, quiet place. If that's not an option, if you're at the office, for instance, take one of these and wear some earplugs as well. There's also some other interesting things you can do regarding naps. And one of those is the coffee nap. Now, this is super, super interesting. Basically, what you do is you drink an entire cup of coffee. Then you set your alarm for 20 minutes. You go right to sleep. And then 20 minutes later, the alarm goes off. You wake up as that coffee's kicking in. So no sleep inertia, no grogginess. Finally, a lot of historical figures talked about how naps actually help them be more creative. So Einstein, Edison, both used naps. Also though, Salvador Dali had a very interesting tactic. And what he did, he would sit in his chair, and then he would take a skeleton key and put it in his hand. He'd hang it down over the side of the chair over a plate. Now, as he fell asleep, his hand would loosen, he would drop the key, it would hit the plate, clank, and wake him up. And he said he'd wake up with more creative ideas. So I wanna try this out for myself. I did, I only had a house key, and I'm not really sure if it worked for me. Anyway, I think if you follow these steps, you should be able to get a good, healthy nap. But if you want more details, I definitely recommend checking out our ultimate guide to naps. If you have any specific questions, just leave a comment below.